In the land of gods and monsters, I was an angel. Living in the garden of evil, screwed up, scared, doing anything that I needed. Shining like a fiery beacon, you've got that medicine I need. Fame, liquor, love, give it to me slowly. Put your hands on my waist, do it softly. Incognito, posing as a real singer. Life imitates art. You got that medicine I need. Hello, 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 my beautiful babies. Happy Halloween. I hope you all enjoyed my little intro. In my singing, okay, singing Gods and Monsters. Oh, I hope everybody is doing wonderful. Thank you so much for joining me, okay? It is 3 a.m. where I am, where the veil is very much thin, where spirits are very much roaming. And I decided to tap in, okay? So that way they can speak through me and tell you what it is that you need to know. Okay. So with that being said, hello, welcome to House of Amenikee. I am the one, the only KW33N Queen, which means knowledge, wisdom, understanding, newbie. And when you put it all together, baby, hope everybody is doing great, feeling great. Hope you're ready to, you know, do your rituals and go trick-or-treating and go to your parties and things of that nature, but be aware as well, because not only the good spirits are out, but also the wicked, the crazy, and the unknown. Okay, so let's get into it, you guys. Also, if you're new here, hello, welcome. Here on this channel, it's nothing but positive vibes, positive energy. Here to tell you what you need to know, not what you want to hear. No, 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 no. We never do that, my dear. And to all of my subscribers, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back, my beautiful babies. Thank you so much for being a part of my family. And I hope those of you who are watching who are not subscribed do become a part of this growing family. Okay. So with that being said, let's get into it. So this is a thin veil spirit message, Halloween pick a card. Okay. So with that being said, I want you all to pick a card. You got pile one. You have the pumpkin. Pile two. You have the cat in the moon. With Anansi, the spider. Those of you who don't know who Anansi is, that's the spider. And you have pile three, the dreadful killer clown. Okay? So I'm going to give you guys a few minutes to pick your pile. Then, once you pick your pile, I want you to go to the timestamps, which will be in the description box. Okay? And it will also be in the comments tab. All right. So that way you can go straight to it. Because it's nothing to it but to do it. So again, you got POW 1, POW 2, POW 3. Pick which one that you want to hear from the queen that the spirits have to say. Okay. All right. So with that being said, now we are going to go ahead and go to POW 1. Okay. What did I do? Okay. There we go. All right. So if you chose POW 1, this is your read. Hello, hello. All right, let's get into it. All right. So the first card that came out for you guys is the owl. Okay. Wise seeing, wise action. Okay. Wild seeing, wild action. And should this hooting owl come looking for you this Halloween, on this Halloween night? Okay, well, it's morning where I'm at, but night is Halloween, early morning. Okay, like I said, 3 a.m. Okay, this card indicates the need for wise counsel or further information before you make a decision, POW 1. Consider action is warranted, and spirit is wanting you to think before you act emotionally and ensure you think strategically, not impulsively. Okay, so spirit wants you to use your brain. Okay, they don't want you to just react to things that, you know, may trigger you or whatever, because it could be something that could put you in a situation that you can't get yourself out of. Okay? And that's why spirit is calling for you to, it says, wise seeing. See things for what it is and act accordingly. Don't lash out. Don't give, you know, all the extra energy. Don't fight fire with fire. Wise action. Move like the owl. Swiftly. Quiet. You know what I'm saying? Be in and out. So whatever is happening to you today, POW 1, don't give it no type of reaction, because whether this is someone or something, it wants a reaction out of you. I just heard it could be your kids, it could be your partner, it could be somebody at your job, it could be anybody, family, anybody. Okay, somebody wants a reaction out of you, and you need to see this person for who they are. I just heard a piece of shit. A piece of shit for who they are. Okay, see people and things for who they are, and you move accordingly, POW 1. Okay, that's what spirit is calling for you to do. The next card that wanted to come out for you guys is Barm Brat. Okay, sweetness and synergy. All right, and when this card comes out, the Barm Brat, it indicates a curiosity to know what is ahead, but it's important to balance that with that. It's important for you. I mean, blah, 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 blah. I'm getting tongue twisted. This card indicates a curiosity to know what is ahead, but it's important to balance that with the now, okay, POW 1? After all, we have the tools to change our future, should we choose, okay? The sweet synergy of Barm Brat, all the ingredients, including the objects, are more complete and powerful together than they are individually should encourage you to seek your own sweet path. Okay? So Spirit is saying it's important for you to stay balanced, to be balanced. Okay? Because you have great things coming to you. Okay? And not only that, I'm hearing you are made up of so much greatness and people want to tear you down. People want to, you know, they want to see the other side of you. People don't, you know, like if you one of those people that's always happy, or even if you got shit going on, but you just look like you're happy, or you may look like you at peace or whatever, you got somebody that wants to disturb your fucking peace. And this is why the Alf card came out for y'all, is to see these people, things, for what they are. You know what I'm saying? And move accordingly. You know what I'm saying? And wise action. You know, don't be foolish. Think before you speak. Think before you react. You know what I'm saying? Because somebody is trying, something or someone wants to, they know you got blessings and things coming. Okay? It's, you can feel it in the atmosphere. A lot of you may feel it in your soul that something is coming, but you just don't know what. You know what I'm saying? And you have the power to change a certain outcome with the way how you handle it. Okay? And everything else will fall into place, but it's up to you to not react, not respond, not give it any energy that it's looking for, and for you to just bless it and just move along. You know what I'm saying? Because sometimes, like I tell people, sometimes you have to think for people. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you got to think for motherfuckers, because people will make you lose your shit. You know? And once upon a time, I used to be a reactor. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, as time has gone on, now I think for people, because it's like, I know I can fuck you up. I know I can fucking kill you. You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to think for your dumb ass. You know what I'm saying? And that's how you got to be, Power One. You got to think for these motherfuckers. Because if not, you the one that's going to lose it all, and you will miss out on what's to come. Okay? Next, you got the veil. Ooh. And look, this is the thin veil spirit messages, okay? The veil, the future. Okay? So, with this card coming out, the veil, the ancient self used to call the time of the longest night of the year the sowing or whatever. They believed that there was a misty veil that separated the world of the dead and the living. But on two nights of the year, Pal One, sowing and Beltane, the shortest night, the veil would be thin, okay? And they knew that it would thin. So the finesse of the veil meant the ancestors were closer than ever, and even the gods would be close. And this would mean that communication from the dead were more likely to occur, and that divination would be more effective. Wherever the divine speaks through something, that's what that means, okay? So, with this oracle card coming out, as the veil lifts and why it is thin, know that the other worlds are close, Pal One. Listen in particular to what messages may come forth around your future. Look to what you want to happen. Plan. Set intentions. Think big. Okay? And this is why it is so careful for you to think before you react, to see, to know what it is that you want out of this realm, out of this life, and not let anyone deter you from it. Okay? Because you got a lot of great things coming to you. And at this time, Spirit is going to show you. Spirit may even speak to you. You may even get signs, synchronicities or something that is going to give you a message or give you a sign that, you know, these things are coming into fruition. Okay? So, Spirit is definitely going to be showing you. And that's why you got to be mindful how you do things at this time, Power One, because you don't want to miss out. Okay? Let's go to the next card. All right. So this is coming from the Priestess of Light. The first cards were coming from the Halloween Oracle. So the number 44 could be of significance. You could be the age 44. Maybe you've been seeing fours. Okay. 4 plus 4 is what? 8. Infinity. Okay. So this card talks about harvest, gathering of blessings. Okay, Power One. So when you receive this card, you are being put on notice that your harvest is coming. There's a project or goal to which you have devoted much effort and attention, and you are about to reap the rewards. What did I just say in your off your first card about the owl with the wise seeing and the wise action? You have things coming, Power One. Blessings, everything, and you have to be mindful in how you move, okay? Okay, so Power One, you have planted your intentions with care and taken the action needed to tend the seeds and cause them to thrive. So if you haven't already seen the fruits of your labor growing in your life, be aware of the potential bountiful results that's about to come your way, Power One. And if there is some work yet to be done, consider the best course of action and make that a priority. Okay? And remember, too, the simultaneity of cause and effect. Even as you harvest, even as you are harvesting the blessings of past actions, you are planting the seeds of future outcomes. So as you ready yourself for the coming harvest, also know that your sacred appreciation for the gifts you're receiving will be seeding the energetic fields with even more joyous results. Okay? So get ready. You have a blessings coming your way. Okay? You put in the hard work and now you're about to reap the benefits, reap everything that you have sown. Okay? Told y'all got nothing but great, amazing things coming your way. So the next card that wanted to come out is the number 31. This is hostilities, conflict, unrest. These cards, it's so crazy how these are from two different piles, decks, and they are just like answering each other. You know what I'm saying? Like speaking to you. Okay. All right. So hostilities, conflict, and unrest. So, Pile One, there may be a person or situation in your life that is abrasive or upsetting in some way, or perhaps something coming in the near future might make you feel defensive. Either way, this card is telling you to gather your resources and turn to the guidance of your own divine light and courage. Okay. Become more conscious of the people or situations zapping your energy or your sense of power. There may be a family member, a coworker, or a draining obligation that has taken toll on you. And even if it has gone on for quite a while, Pal One, it's finally time to choose to protect yourself and your own energy. This choice may cause others to be upset or even hostile with you, Pal One. Okay? So, because you may be tempted to diffuse the conflict by giving in, but that old unhealthy pattern must be resisted at this time, Pal One. Okay? This is so, like, your cards are talking about, wow, thank you, Spirit. I just kept hearing whistling. Okay. You may never, and ain't nobody, anywho. I'm just listening to Spirit right now. I'm sorry, you guys. You don't have to give in into those habits of fear anymore, or into toxic shit or people. You know what I'm saying? So don't shy away from conflict or unrest. You deserve to act on your own behalf. Be brave in the face of confrontation and know that you are capable of seeing it through to the other side. You have the fierce determination and strength of the panther within you. That lion or that lioness within you, okay? And the light of divine assistance is always on hand, all right? So you hold the power. You hold the power to not give in, to not, you know what I'm saying, give any of your energy to things and people that want a reaction out of you, Power One. Oh my God. It's like, I just been saying this the whole time since the beginning of the read. Next card you got is the number one. It's Portal, Infinite Mind, Awakening Consciousness. Okay, so with this, when this card shows up in your spread, Power One, you'll find yourself making spontaneous honoring decisions, trusting your choices, and clearly seeing the future potentials coming into your life. The portal marks a time of expanding consciousness. Open to the guidance of your own eternal mind and look to the future with confidence. And also, this card heralds the coming of a very powerful time for you. It signifies no less than the awakening of your infinite and eternal awareness. A golden radiance encircles the crown chakra and third eye of this sacred priestess that's here on this card, representing the profound connections that reach from your own mind to the unlimited power of divine source. This is the portal of your ultimate experience of inspiration. Okay, Power One? So you are tapping in. Okay, you are awakening. You are stepping into your power, moving forward, Power One. Okay? And things, it's like you can manifest whatever it is that you want or whatever, as long as you stay at a high vibration and not let these things or these people try to bring you down or try to interfere in some way of trying to knock you off and take you off of your path. Okay? So the next pal The next cards we are going to be reading from is your goddess guidance oracle messages. So the first card that came out for you guys is Astara, fertility. It is the time. It is the perfect time for you to start new projects, access new ideas, and give birth to new conditions. So this card talks about, you know, embarking on new ventures, new beginnings coming your way, okay? Birthing, you know, ideas. For some of you, it could actually be birthing a child. You know what I'm saying? Just starting something new, starting something fresh, okay? Next is Vesta, home, okay? Your household situation is improving. I can't talk, y'all. Whoever the spirit is speaking to me, they blah, 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 blah. They are like, okay, your household situation is improving, either through a move or a healthy change in the occupants. Okay, so some of you, you could be moving. Okay, and some of you, you may have been wondering, you know, if something is going to come through for you. The answer is yes. You are about to embark on a new beginning. Okay, the desires of your heart is here. For some of you, you could be moving away from someone. It could be someone that has been trying to get a reaction, somebody that has been causing drama, stress, whatever. You could be moving away from someone as well. Okay. Also with this fertility card here, and it's talking about there could be a change in occupants in the home. I'm hearing for some of you, you could be adding to your family. Okay. And this is this could be your confirmation that, you know, this read is for you. Some of you could be with child. Okay. But not necessarily. For some of you, this can indicate that people will be leaving the home, or you will be leaving a home to go into a new home. Okay. Next, you got Aphrodite or Aphrodite. Everybody pronounces it differently. Inner goddess. Awaken the goddess within you through dance, self-care, and appreciating your divinity. So spirit wants you to pour into yourself, you know what I'm saying? Self-love, love up on you, take care of yourself, start paying attention to yourself, okay? Not only that, they want you to awaken the inner god or the inner goddess within yourself. Be that sexy or that handsome you, you know what I'm saying? Show off your beauty, show off your handsomeness, all of that. Okay, this is your time to tap into yourself, pour into you. Okay, because clearly it was other people that wasn't doing that for you. All right, so let's move along. Next, we have the next pile of cards that we're reading from. This is from Believe in Your Own Magic Oracle deck. And the first card that came out is the number 18. This is the tree. Let them go. Yes, it is time to let go of certain people and things that have been causing problems in your life. Okay? It's time to detach, all right? Because somebody is trying to block your blessing. And this is why that owl, wise seeing, wise action. That's why spirit is calling for you to think before you react. You know what I'm saying? Think before you speak. Think before you do anything. Or think for this motherfucker. Or think for these people, period. Okay, let things and people go that no longer serve you, because they're only holding you up from progressing and from your blessings. All right, y'all. 1 + 8 = 9, so 9 could be of significance to you. Okay, next you have the number 45. Some of you could be 45, don't have to be. 4 + 5 = 9. Okay. Next, you have throne. Your potential is endless. Okay. Yes. The things that are about to be coming your way, you're about to have endless blessings, pile one. Okay? Your potential is endless. Nobody can stop you. Whoever's trying to stop you, they can't. Because guess what? What's for you is for you, pile one. Okay? And can't nobody stop. Can't nobody do a goddamn thing. All right? Message. Okay? Yes. So can't nobody stop you from being great or anything, or stop the blessings that the divine has for you that is coming your way. Okay. The next card that we're reading from is your soul's journey. The message is regret. I know that I cannot change the past. Some of you may regret, you know, certain things from the past. You may regret certain ways and actions that you could have been or that you should have done. You know what I'm saying? But Spirit is saying, you know, things that may have transpired, it's no need to be in regret. You know, the people or the person that you were dealing with, you know, you might regret that, you know, you even gave to somebody or that you even invested your time in somebody. You may felt like, you know, I regret the fact that I wasted my motherfucking time and my energy. You know what I'm saying? I could have gave it to somebody else, but instead I gave it to your raggedy ass. You know what I'm saying? Or you regret that you didn't speak up, or you regret, you know, whatever it is, pile one, you know your story, okay? But Spirit is saying, I know that I cannot change the past. You can't change the past, so now it's time to move forward. What's done is done, okay? So Spirit is saying, stop beating yourself up and stop being in regret, and it's time to move on. Next card that came out for you guys, this is coming from the... This is coming from the Keepers of Light Oracle. Okay. Your message is Joan of Arc, voice of truth, pile one. Stand strong. Focus on your purpose. Release the fear of persecution and speak your truth. Okay. So you got the strength of Joan of Arc. Okay. Joan of Arc is coming through saying, voice your truth, speak your truth, stand in your, you know, stand firm, stand tall. Don't let nothing or no one, you know, bully you or try to push you in a way or make you hide yourself. You know what I'm saying? That's what they want you to do. They want you to, you know, not embark on your journey. They want you to settle for any and everything. They want to hold you back. And Spirit is saying, don't let them do that. Stand firm, speak your truth, and do the damn thing. Okay? So your room message to close you out, pile one, is Sowilo, the sun. Okay? This symbolizes health, honor, resources, victory, wholeness, cleansing. Must I say anything else about this read? All your cards have intertwined with each other. This whole message, pile one. Everything, you're about to have resources that can help you. You're about to get victory over your enemies and over those that have made you feel less than. You're about to feel wholeness. Whole again. Some of you may have been broken. You're about to be whole again. A lot of you, your health is going to be improving. Some of y'all were stressed out. Some of y'all were going through. Some of y'all probably some mental, you know what I'm saying? Some I'm hearing for some of y'all, you may have wanted to end it. You know what I'm saying? And with cleansing, Spirit is saying it's time for you to cleanse these people out of your life, meaning get rid of them. Just like that tree card said, it said, let them go. Let them go. It's no need to hold on. Okay? Pile one, you got blessings coming in. Your future, everything looks bright. All right? That is your message. I hope this gave you insight. And I hope you are ready for what's to come, pile one. Let me know in the description. Let me know in the comments if you are ready. All right. I love you guys. Next, let's go to pile two. Okay, let's go to the next card. Oh, and another thing, you guys, if you haven't already, today is the last day, pile one for my sales in my store, okay? The next sale won't be until Black Friday, but today's the last day. If you want to get your spiritual waters, candles, soaps, herbs, if you want readings, okay, still got 50% going on the readings and 25% going on the other items in the store, okay? So make sure you give this a thumbs up, like, share, subscribe. All right, Power One, stay blessed, fuck stress. Why Power One? Because you're the motherfucking best. Now we're going to move on to Power Two. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to Pow 2. This is your Pow, and this is your Thin Veil Spirit Message, Pow 2. So let's get into it. So you got the Lady of the Dead. For those of you who don't know who that is the one, the only Lady de los Muertos. Okay? Yes, with her beautiful soul. And this card talks about acceptance and equality, okay? And Spirit is saying, Power One, acknowledging that death is a natural process that will enter everyone's life at some time, and that perhaps until then we can choose to be life-affirming takes away much of the fear. Take a light approach to a situation initially, and it may work out better. If you are holding on to something that does not serve you any longer, in particular material things, simply let it go. Okay? So with this coming out, Lady Muertos is coming through very strongly in y'all read, saying, you know, if something isn't bringing you peace, if it's not bringing you happiness, all things must die and wither away, not just in the physical death, but also in the spiritual sense. You know what I'm saying? Also in a, you know, relationship or whatever. And all things come to an end. You know, things take its courses. And Lady de los Muertos, she wants you to accept what has ended, accept all that has transpired or whatever, and not only that, it's time for you to embark on a journey where you will be accepted and equal wholeheartedly with somebody that sees you and that matches you is also what I'm hearing as well. So kind of, yeah, I'm sorry, y'all, so many messages coming through my head that if y'all could see my face, y'all would be like, Queen, are you okay? Because got my eyes closing and shit, so I'm just trying to communicate to y'all and I'm sounding fucking retarded the way how I'm talking because I'm just trying to download and understand. Okay, but anywho, yes, acceptance and equality, you know, it's things and people that don't accept you for who you are, Pow to, you know what I'm saying? And you will meet your tribe of those who are like-minded, those who are on the same plane, those who are on the same wave, as well as what I'm hearing. Things and people that was not serving you for your highest good, or, you know, they didn't get you, or maybe y'all wasn't equal or whatever, or, you know, had nothing in common. Spirit is saying, let that go and let it wither away. Next, you got the Strength card. This is the Skeleton. Okay? And with this card coming out, Spirit is saying, dare to show strength and vulnerability if that is what you really feel. Shame, pride, grudges, or embarrassment are hefty burdens that need not be carried through the darkest of nights. Okay? And spirit wants you to release. All right? That's why I say things die. You know, that's what Lady De Los Muertos was saying about, like, certain shit got to come to an end. And spirit is calling for you to find the strength in yourself to move on, to carry on, to leave certain things and people behind. Okay? You might have years with the person, you know what I'm saying? Or you might have long, you know, y'all got a long history, and you might feel so comfortable, but you might also feel like, you know, you really don't want to let go, or you don't want to walk away from something because of the fact of how long you've been with someone, or whatever the case may be. But spirit is saying, no, it's time to go. And find someone who is equal with you. Somebody that's on the same wavelength, that's on the same thing. Somebody that's going to accept you and love you and be with you for who you are. You know what I'm saying? Not so much of you having to change and rearrange who you are just so somebody could be and stay in your life. Okay? And spirit is saying, just get the strength to move on, to carry on, because what's ahead for you is going to make you very much happy, okay? And that leads to the apple, okay? Risk and reward. Yeah, so whatever it is that you are being called to leave behind, you got the apple, risk and reward. By you taking a risk towards love, and see if y'all can see this apple, it has a heart carved in it. Or whatever. And for a lot of you, this is pertaining to love. You know what I'm saying? Spirit is calling for you to take the risk to step out and get what it is that you want. Be with who it is that you want to be with. You know what I'm saying? Because it's great rewards when you do that, Power One. It's great rewards. Okay, and it's time to look at how risk plays out in your life as well. I say Power One. I meant Power Two. I'm sorry. Power Two, y'all might have to look at Power One, because it's like y'all messages are somewhat kind of similar a little bit. And maybe for some of you, you may have been like, I don't know, I'm going to choose Power One. Or whatever, but you wind up choosing Power Two. So if you were indecisive about which one or whatever, and maybe you were drawn to both, go back and look at Power One reading after this. Okay, there's a message in there for you. Or this could just be indicating that a lot of y'all need to watch Power One, because it's a message in there, period. Okay, but anywho, it's time for you to see how risk plays in your life at this time. Spirit wants to know, are you hedging your bets and not trying anything new? You know, are you keeping to yourself? Are you not really trying to start something new with someone or whatever? Do you want change, but you are not willing to change anything? Are you willing to risk to get a greater reward, or eternally, are you risking too much too often? You know what I'm saying? Are you giving to the wrong people? Are you risking for the wrong reasons and to the wrong people? And spirit wants you to ask yourself these things. And not only that, they want you to take great risks, because whoever or whatever you need to take a risk on to embark on something new or whatever, you have great rewards coming your way. And for a lot of you, I feel like this is love again, because it has the heart and the apple. And this is what y'all read is talking about so far or whatever. Taking a risk or whatever and going towards something or someone who you haven't yet experienced. You get what I'm saying? And when you do that, the desires of your heart will come into fruition when you embark on this journey with something and someone new. Okay? So the next card we picked from, okay, so the first deck that we read from, this was the Halloween Oracle. And the next one, this is your Priestess of the Light Oracle messages. Okay, so the first card that came out is the number 25. Maybe 25 could be of significance. 2 + 5 = 7. Okay, maybe y'all been seeing sevens, or maybe 7 is significant. You got this card says, go with the flow, letting go, cleansing, and receiving. Okay, so when this card appears in your spread, it announces a time of quiet energy, encouraging you to release resistance and go with the flow. All right, pile two. Okay, I'm telling you, it's a message in there for y'all. Yeah, and it's time for you to go with the flow of things. True release requires a conscious intention to let go of control and embrace the cleansing energy of non-attachment. Okay? And pile two, it's time to step back and reevaluate things. Take a break from trying to force your will and open your heart to the guidance of the spirit flowing within and around you. This doesn't mean you should take no action. It means your action should flow with your intuition. Okay? So spirit is calling for you to let go of what no longer serves you. If it's dead, it hasn't been working for a long time with you and someone, or whether it's a job or whatever the case is, it's ran its course. Spirit is saying it's time to let go, cleanse your energy of that person or whatever the situation is, and be open to receiving what it is that you want. Okay? Be open to going after what it is that you want and what it is that you have been, you know, calling in and all that good stuff. Okay, so the next card is the number 50. The number 50 can be of significance to you. Number 5 could be of significance to you. This card is talking about sacred gratitude, reverent appreciation, and prayer. Okay, so this card is telling you to let go of external concerns long enough to spend some time in sacred gratitude at this time. Okay, this reverent appreciation calls for you to pause and reflect, to truly feel value of your life, pal, too, and your earthly environment down to the depths of your very soul. This is not so much about listing of all the good things you already have as it is about to simply experiencing the wonder of being. Okay, pile two, and being one with nature and one with your soul and one with the planet and everything on it. This mystical approach is easy to adopt through a meditative thought, a deep breath, or a quiet smile. And spirit wants you to be careful not to dismiss this choice as frivolous. Okay, this inwardly peace intention is actually a dynamic energy accelerator. Each quiet, uncluttered moment of gratitude will summon the communal grace of both the creative and magnetic forces flowing through the world as you can ride these energetic waves with joy. So take some time, pal, to engage in this deeper sense of gratitude now and get ready for what's to come your way, and let go of external concerns and stop to appreciate life's deeper value. Okay, and give gratitude for what is already in front of you. Okay, next you have the number 24, adjustment, looking back and moving forward. Okay, so when I look at this card and basically what it's talking about, somebody's looking back and moving. This is adjustments. So now it's time for you to make adjustments. Okay, a lot of you could be looking back at the past and, you know, making some adjustments like, I want something different this time. I want, you know, X, Y, Z or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And this card marks a pause in your energy, a time to contemplate what you've been doing and determine if any changes would prove beneficial into your life right now. And reflection and course correction now are wiser than charging full steam ahead. Okay. And this could call for some patience and courage for you. And you may have to shift or even abandon the path that has been your primary focus, pal too. But take note of the bright light or whatever that's coming your way and that's lighting your path to a new beginning. Okay? For you to move forward from whoever or whatever this person is. Okay? And that is, you're being called to continue. I just heard, keep on moving. Keep on moving. Don't stop. No. So just keep moving. Okay? Because you're gonna move to where it is that is for you, where everything is aligned. Okay? And a lot of you are being called to make adjustments. Maybe it could be, you know, certain thoughts, certain things and ways how you handle certain things. It could be within you, period. Whatever you know you need to work on. You know what I'm saying? All right, so next we are going to be reading from the goddess guidance. Okay, so your goddess guidance messages, you got Arakura, blossoming. Okay, this card is saying you are just getting started. So have patience with yourself and the process and do not give up. So a lot of you are just getting started on embarking this new journey, you know, detaching and leaving something and someone behind. And Spirit is saying, keep moving, keep pushing. You are growing, you are blossoming into who it is that you are meant to be and who you have been yearning to be. Okay. Next, you have Sullis, bodies of water. Spend time near water, such as a lake, river, or the ocean to recharge your batteries. Yeah, a lot of you are drained, and a lot of you need to sit in nature, sit in water at this time. You know what I'm saying? Just to relax. If you're not near a lake or ocean or something, I just heard, take a bath. You know what I'm saying? Relax. Kind of just talk to the water and tell the water what it is that you wanted to do is another thing that I just heard. Okay. Next, you got Sarasavasti, the arts. Express yourself through creative activities. Okay. So a lot of you are very creative. I could be speaking to, you know, creators who create music, who do art, who, you know, you do something creative, some type of thing that's creative, okay? Whatever it is that you might do. Paint, write, whatever, okay? That's for you. Spirit wants you to tap in at this time. Next cards that we're reading from is Believe in Your Own Magic. The first card that came out for you guys is the number 3, Tower. Unplug and relax for a spell. Okay, so a lot of you could have been going through a tower moment, okay, where things had to fall, things had to end, okay? Endings bring in new beginnings, and that goes back to Lady de los Muertos. Something had to end, you know, something had to die out or whatever. And yeah, now is the time for you to unplug and relax. You know what I'm saying? Take time out for you at this time. And the reason why you need to do that, the next card that wants to come out for you is feast. Slow down and celebrate yourself. Number 29 could mean something to you, okay? So spirit wants you to slow down, you know, kind of take your time on things. You don't have to rush. There's no rush, okay? And spirit wants you to celebrate yourself, love up on yourself, appreciate yourself at this time, okay? The next card that we're going to be reading from is your soul's journey. Okay, so the card that came out for you guys is happiness. You got a lot of happiness coming your way. A lot of great things coming your way. And this card is saying, I am aware of being happy means that I am on the right path. Yes, when you are happy, you're on the right path. When you're not feeling stagnant or if you're not feeling like drained or you're not feeling unhappy about being in a particular certain situation or whatever the case may be, and you're happy, you know what I'm saying? Happy times is coming if it hasn't already. All right, the next message that came out for you guys, this is coming from the Keepers of the Light message. So you got Master Jesus. You know, whichever one you want to call, forgiveness, okay? You are on the path of light, love, and forgiveness. Father healing is possible at this time. So spirit wants you to forgive those that may have hurt you, okay? Because you have this special light within yourself and that shines so bright, and you don't need to let your light or nothing dim for no pieces of shit that couldn't appreciate who you were and couldn't see you for who you were. You know what I'm saying? So forgive them, bless, and keep it moving. Keep going on about your business. All right? So to close you out, pile two, we're going to see what your rune card is. Your rune is Bercano. This is talking about the birch tree. Symbolizes femininity, fertility, healing, regeneration, birth, okay? So yeah, a lot of you are about to go on this new beginning. You are embarking on a new beginning, okay? New things is happening. A lot of you are going to be healing as well, healing from heartache, pain, whatever somebody has put you through, okay? Woo! Excuse me, you guys. I had to yarn. but yeah, spirit is calling for you to get ready to embark on this new beginning and embark on this new chapter in your life. Okay? Some of you could be birthing a child or just birthing something new. It could be an idea. It could be anything. All right? Now is the time to tap in and get it on and popping. All right. So you guys, make sure you give this video a thumbs up, like, share, subscribe if you haven't already. And this is your read for The Veil Is Thin and all that good stuff. And I will see y'all in the next pile. So stay blessed. Fuck stress. Why pile two? Because you the motherfucking best. And that's on period. Okay. So let's go to pile three.